The 11th, shortest hole on the golf course, it makes the players think. It's not a hole where you can win the championship, but it's certainly one where you can lose it.
Is this a shot that you practice on the range specifically?
No.
It's not, I mean, that's not something that you would have to check chipping 8 or 9 or something.
No, I mean, okay. I would normally do that on the range anyway, but okay. I'm not specifically doing it for this hole.
Neither.
It's awesome. Every course should have something like this. A lot better than any par 3 over 200 yards, that's for sure.
On this hole, they haven't used it since when Matt played. So when you're looking at this hole, I was asking JT the same thing. Are you practicing this ahead of time? Is it something that you're focused on in your preparation?
I wouldn't say I'm focused on this hole, but like, for instance, those chippy shots is definitely something that I'm always practicing. Like when I'm at home or on the range after the round, like
okay.
Those are shots that I'm constantly working on.
Thought process here, is it attack the flag or center of the green?
Depends where it is, because I got some good pins there in the front. I would say if it's more in the back, you can probably be fairly aggressive with it. Just depends on how close they tuck it towards the edge.
If they move it up and they, you know, have a flag on the front of the green and a tee is up there, will you be aggressive with that?
Well, I think what they're going to do is they're going to put it up front and then put the pin front left. And I was doing some research at it yesterday. It's a really small area, so probably play kind of towards the edge of it and then maybe get a bounce and kick it in. If not, I'm still kind of in the middle of the green.
We'll just do what you just did here on Wednesday.
Yeah, only it was that easy.
What'd you say? Hit it close and make it.
Thanks, man. See ya.